Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Book Lounge this evening. Thanks for joining us for the launch of this fabulous, wonderful, lovely novel, Tribe, by the fabulous, wonderful, lovely person on my immediate right, Rahla Xenopoulos. We're absolutely thrilled tonight, firstly, to be hosting the launch of this wonderful book, but also because in conversation with Rahla this evening is, of course, there's so many different words one could use to describe her. So we'll just go with actress, TV show host, comedian, writer, kind of important, completely irrelevant friend of Rahla's, apparently. It's wonderful to have Ruby Wax with us here this evening, so please give a warm welcome to Ruby as well.
Before he sees Benji's new girlfriend, the babe, or any of his friends, before seeing anything beyond the laughing Tsalani, Jude sees a coffee table in the center of the lounge. It's got a certain look. He had a theory in first year. If you wanted to analyze a girl, forget Freud, go to her home. Whatever you noticed first symbolized the essence of her character. If it was her music collection, she loved dancing. Books, she didn't live in this world. Photos, she lived in the past. Bed, she loved to fuck. Once, he went to a girl's place, just one room in student digs, and there in the middle was a four-poster bed covered in pink linen. Virgin.
What redeems them?
I think as a generation, they're kind of unlike most of their generation because they are that glamorous and that entitled and that wealthy and that good looking, and they've got a lot going for them which the rest of us don't have. But I think Generation X, we've messed up a lot. We really have. I was writing something the other day and I was saying what we're handing our children is a huge mess and we're expecting them to fix it up. And I think these kids are a lot more conscientized and a lot more aware and socialized than we were as children. But there was a phase when Generation X, we were very idealistic and there was this thing that everyone was, I always say, you know, when you're taking all this E and you like on a dance floor and you think, oh, God, this friendship is so deep and I've made this huge connection with this person and we're going to be friends for life. And then you wake up in the morning and you think, well, so who the fuck was that? And I've got such a hangover. And I think Generation X was a lot about that. There was a lot of hangovers for a while. And there was the internet coming out, and we thought, for a lot of us, we thought we've got this internet and we're going to change the world with it. And it was kind of like the new age of Aquarius. And we've really, in a large way, we've missed that boat. The internet has been corporatized. And there's a lot of disappointment for a lot of us from that. Maybe we're crawling our way, maybe we're getting it back and realizing our mistakes. So a lot of the book was about this group of people trying to regain that idealism, trying to regain themselves and regain the idealism of their youth.
A very, very big thank you to Rahla Xenopoulos for being with us and for this wonderful, wonderful book.
I spent my time watching the spaces that have grown between us, and I cut my mind on second best, all the scars that come with the greenness, and I gave my eyes to the boredom. Still the seabed wouldn't let me in, and I tried my best to embrace the darkness in which I swim.